الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونتوب إليه، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهدي الله فهو المهتدي، ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل وبارك على عبدك ورسولك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We praise Him, we seek help from Him, we ask forgiveness from Him, we seek refuge in Him from our own evils and our own bad deeds. Anyone who has been guided by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is indeed guided. And anyone who has been misguided, you will never find a guardian to guide him. They bear witness that there is no deity except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, without any partner. They bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is His servant and His messenger. O Allah, let your prayer, your peace, and blessing be upon your servant Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his family and all his companions. In continuation of the seers of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's ethic, we still with the ethic of the al-istighfar, seeking forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is a long series of khutbahs about al-istighfar, because we are addressing most of the verses and most of the hadith, and there are many of them. And that shows how important it is to make istighfar all the time. Istighfar is a very important thing in your life, that you make istighfar, seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on things that you know and things that you don't know. Because you may do something that you are not aware of, that this is not right, and you should ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive you for it, because you are not aware of it. So istighfar, make it a good habit that you make istighfar all the time. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to make istighfar more than 70 times a day. 70 times a day. So we should make istighfar all the time, and as you can see from the Quran al-Kareem, that the verses that we make istighfar for forgiveness, make istighfar for accomplishing our goals, making istighfar for getting what you're looking for. Istighfar is the gate for accomplishment of all what you seek in good things to from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In Surah Ghafir, verse from 1 to 3, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajeem, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Hameem, Tanzeelul kitabi min Allahi al-Aziz al-Aleem, Ghafir al-Zamb, Wa qabil al-Tawb, Shadeedul al-Iqab, Zittul la ilaha illa huwa, Ilayhi al-Masir. Hameem, this is letters that the challenging people of the Arabs was with their language to know, which is nobody knows exactly what this letters means, only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows. Tanzeel al-kitab min Allah al-Aziz al-Alim, the book of the Quran al-Kareem, indeed, it's coming from Allah, the Magnificent, Allah the most knowledgeable, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the Exalted. Ghafir al-Zamb, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only one who forgives the sins. وَقَابِلِ التَّوْبِ, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only one who accepts the repentance. So He forgives the sins and accepts the repentance. Because after you make istighfar, you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for repentance, not to go back again to the same sins. شَدِيدُ الْعِقَابِ تُطَّوْلِ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُوَ إِلَيْهِ الْمَصِيرِ. So qabil al-tawb, shadeed al-iqab, but keep in mind also, it's a both sides. If you are not going to make istighfar, if you are not going to repent, know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who is going to punish, and it's severe punishment. So you should better make istighfar and make repentance all the time, so you can win to go to the paradise and stay away from any punishment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the day of judgment. The tawli, this means that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala he has the upper hand of everything. He's the most generous, he's the most forgiving, he's the most the one who give blessings. Everything is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has the upper hand, the power. لا إله إلا هو إليه المصير. No God except He, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and all we will return to Him. In Surah Ghafir also from verse 38 to 42, بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وقال الذي آمن يا قوم اتبعوني أهدكم سبيل الرشاد. The person who the believer who asked the people to follow him, he was going to show them the right path. يا قوم إنما هذه الحياة الدنيا متاع وإن الآخرة هي دار القرار. Oh my people, this life is short. It's very short. It's not going to last long comparing to the everlasting afterlife. When the akhirati adar al qarar, the afterlife is the one that's going to stay forever. It's going to stay forever. So you should work for it. This is not life. This is a bridge to the afterlife, which is the real life. The real life is the one that you're going to stay there forever. When you imagine, when you think about forever. Forever you're going to be in the paradise, and God forever you're going to be in the hellfire. So choose the one that's going to be for the paradise and work for that. من عمل سيئة فلا يجزى إلا مثلها ومن عمل صالحا من ذكر أو أنثى وهو مؤمن فأولئك يدخلون الجنة ويرزقون فيها بغير حساب. Whoever will make sin, whoever commits sin, is going to be punished according to that sin. There is no extra. But when you make good deeds from either male or female, and you are a believer, because very important you believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you make good deeds. أولئك يدخلون الجنة يرزقون فيها بغير حساب. Look at this. أولئك يدخلون الجنة. Those people who are going to get into the paradise and you're going to get provisions without any measurements. When you say يدخلون الجنة يرزقون فيها بغير حساب without measurements, this is according to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala generosity. But without measurements that we cannot comprehend how much is it. Without measurements, this means that you cannot believe with your mind, with your heart, that you don't know, because it's out of our limits of measurements. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only knows about it. When you know that the least person has in the paradise is the one who will have, like the one who owned the whole earth that we live on now. This the whole earth, that's the least kingdom for the person who is living in the paradise. Which you can imagine who else. And this is the least one. And how many degrees of ranks and higher in the paradise. So work for that. Work for that, because you for sure you want to stay forever in the paradise. Work for that, because for sure you will not like to be punished. Work for that, because you like to see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Seeing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the best reward that you're going to get in the paradise. Whatever pleasure you're going to be in the paradise is nothing. The maximum pleasure for you to see the face of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the paradise. وَيَا قَوْمْ مَا لِي أَدْعُوكُمْ إِلَى النَّجَاةِ وَتَدْعُونَنِي إِلَى النَّارِ. So these people who, the man, the believer, was guiding the people to rescue themselves, to rescue themselves from the hellfire, to rescue themselves from the wrongdoing. And he said, instead, I'm inviting you to risk yourself from hellfire, and you inviting me to the hellfire. I'm asking you to be on the safe side, and you inviting me to go on the wrong side. تدعونني لأكفر بالله وأشرك به ما ليس لي به علما وأنا أدعوكم إلى العزيز الغفار. You inviting me to have associates with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I don't know about. I am inviting you to the most forgiving, to the most exalted, to the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one. So you inviting me to the hellfire, and I'm inviting you to the paradise. I'm inviting you to be with Allah, the Creator, and you're inviting me to be with associates that you have no power with for even for themselves. They cannot even help themselves. In another surah, Fussilat, verse 30 to 32, and it says, always keep in mind, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most exalted, the most forgiving. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَا اللَّهُ ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا تَتَنَزَّلُ عَلَيْهِمُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ أَلَّا تَخَافُوا وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا وَأَبْشِرُوا بِالْجَنَّةِ الَّتِي كُنْتُمْ تُوَعَدُونَ. The people who said that our Lord is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they are in the straight path, the angels come on them, the angels descend on them, and they comfort them, and telling them that don't be afraid, don't be sad, and the paradise is your reward, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you for, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promise you for it. So when you with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala right path, the angels would be with you. But if you go with the devils and the is going to be with you. So choose your way. نحن أولياؤكم في الحياة الدنيا وفي الآخرة ولكم فيها ما تشتهي أنفسكم ولكم فيها ما تدعون. So the companions, your companions will be the angels. Could you imagine that you're going to, when you are on the right path, the angels will be your companions. The companions who are going to be with you to protect you, to pray for you, to help you in all your matters. And in this life, and in afterlife, glad tidings from the angels that you're going to have all what you want in the paradise, and all what you've been promised. So choose your way. This too very clear. Nuzulam min ghafurun rahim, and this is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You're going to be in the paradise from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most forgiving, the most merciful. This is what you just keep in mind. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most forgiving, the most merciful. So stick with that and get what you want to get from these names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, beautiful names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. From Surah Fussilat, verse 43, مَا يُقَالُ لَكَ إِلَّا مَا قَدْ قِيلَ لِلرُّسُلُ مِنْ قَبْلِكَ إِنَّ رَبَّكَ لَذُو مَغْفَرَةٍ وَذُو عِقَابٍ أَلِيمٍ. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descended in the Quran al-Kareem and is telling Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam exactly what the previous messengers and the previous prophets being said to them. إِنَّ رَبَّكَ لَذُو مَغْفَرَةٍ وَذُو عُقَابٍ أَلِيمٍ. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, your Lord, is the most forgiving, and at the same time, He is the one who will have severe punishment on the disbelievers. So choose the way, most forgiving, or the severe punishment. So you should go with the most forgiven and stay away from the punishment, because this punishment is severe. It's severe that we cannot even know how severe it is. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep us away from the hellfire, and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us and to keep us in the paradise. أقول قولي هذا أستغفر الله لي ولكم. أدعو الله أن تكون هذه ساعة إجابة. Supplicate, may Allah accept our supplication at this time. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي. يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما صليت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم. وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما باركت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. In Surah Shura, verse 22 and 23, بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ترى الظالمين مشفقين مما كسبوا وهو واقع بهم والذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات في روضات الجنات لهم ما يشاءون عند ربهم ذلك هو الفضل الكبير. In the day of judgment, everything will be clear. Everything you're going to see, the people who are oppressors, the people who did wrong in their life, you're going to see what happened to them. You're going to see them. You're going to know them. You're going to so you will know what Allah Subhanahu wa Taala promised is happening, and that severe punishment is going to be. You will see why they are suffering. And also at the same time, you're going to look and see the believers who did the right things in the paradise. You're going to see both. You're going to have your sight is not going to be limited. Your sight going to have access to see everything. The severe punishment in the hellfire, people punished, and also that you will see the people in the paradise enjoying their paradise, and within the paradise, whatever they want, Allah Subhanahu wa Taala will give them. Because when you are in the paradise, whatever you ask is done to be in front of you, And you ask Allah Subhanahu wa Taala because you work for that. ذَلِكَ هُوَ الْفَضْلُ الْكَبِيرُ. So this is the most blessing. This is the most blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that when you are in the paradise, and that is no work, no more work. You're just going to enjoy forever whatever you worked for. And this is very important to know that whatever you work, this is a time to work for how you're going to live forever after that. This is just like you're studying for the exam. After you pass the exam, that's it. You enjoy the result of the exam. ذَلِكَ الَّذِي يُبَشِّرُ اللَّهُ عِبَادَهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ قُلْ لَا أَسْأَلُكُمْ عَلَيْهِ أَجْرًا إِلَّا الْمَوَدَّةَ فِي الْقُرْبَى وَمَنْ يَقْتَرِفْ حَسَنَةً نَجِدْ لَهُ فِيهَا حُسْنًا إِنَّ اللَّهَ غَفُورٌ شَكُورٌ. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is delivering this message through the Quran al-Kareem. ذلك الذي يبشر الله عباده إن الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات. For these people who believed and they did the right things, Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم is telling that you, I'm not asking you for rewards from you. The rewards of Prophet Muhammad is not going to be from us. All what you do to be good to his family. And to but the rewards is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And whoever will commit a good deed is going to be multiplied. This is the difference. When you do wrong deed, it's going to be it. But if you do good deed, it's going to be multiplied. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will beautify it, will make it bigger and bigger. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most forgiving and the most thankful. Because وَإِن شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ. When you thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the blessings that you have, and you have a lot of blessings. Don't think that you don't have blessings. You have blessings that are unlimited. When you just count, write down the blessings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have in you. Unlimited. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when you thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for this blessing, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you more. Will give you more, not necessarily here, but will give you more in rewards, more in blessings that you're going to receive. Since you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgiveness and you thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In Surah Al-Ahqaf, verses 7 and 8, وَإِذَا تُتْلَى عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُنَا بَيِّنَاتٍ قَالَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا لِلْحَقِّ لما جاءهم هذا سحر مبين أم يقولون افتراه قل إن افتريته فلا تملكون لي من الله شيئا هو أعلم بما تفيضون فيه كفى به شهيدا بيني وبينكم وهو الغفور الرحيم. Now whenever Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam reciting the Quran al-Kareem for disbelievers, they going to say, this is a magic. This is a great magic. They don't believe. Although before the Prophethood of Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, they knew that he is honest. He called him the honest person. Al-Amin, Al-Sadiq, the most truthful, the most honest before that. But after he came with this verse from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they said this is a magic, it's a great magic. So, أَمْ يَقُولُونَ افْتَرَاهُ قُلْ إِنْ افْتَرَيْتُ فَلَمْ تَمْلِكُونَ لِي مِنْ اللَّهِ شَيْئًا. If I fabricated this, you are not going to be, you are not the one who is going to judge me. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who is going to judge. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most knowledgeable and knows everything. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a witness between me and you. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most forgiving and the most merciful. So after all this, after all what they do, what they disbelieve and what they don't follow, still Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to be the most merciful and the most forgiving for them. Also in another verse, Surah Al-Najm, verse 31 to 32, وَلِلَّهِ مَا فِي السَّمَوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ لِيَجْزِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسَاءُوا بِمَا عَمِلُوا وَيَجْزِي الَّذِينَ أَحْسَنُوا بِالْحُسْنَى. It's always between the people who do wrong and the people who do right. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala going to punish the people who are doing wrong. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala going to reward the people who is doing good. الَّذِينَ يَجْتِنُبُونَ كَبَائِلَ الْإِثْمُ وَالْفَوَاحِشِ إِلَّا اللَّمَمْ إِنَّ رَبَّكَ وَاسِعُ الْمَغْفِرَةِ وَأَعْلَمُ بِكُمْ إِذْ أَنْشَأَكُمْ مِنَ الْأَرْضِ وَإِذْ أَنْتُمْ أَجِنَّةٌ فِي بُطُونِ أُمَّهَاتِكُمْ فَلَا تُزَكُّوا أَنفُسَكُمْ هُوَ أَعْلَمُ بِمَنِ اتَّقَى. Now, as long as you stay away from the big sins, when you stay away from the big sins, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you ask Allah for forgiveness, you will be forgiven. So fight to stay away from wrongdoings. Fight to stay away from the big sins. And always ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness, because what you do, you may be doing something is not the right thing. So always ask Allah for forgiveness and guidance. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most knowledgeable. He's the one, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He's the one who created us in the wombs of our mothers. So you know who you are. When you look at the baby and how weak they are and how helpless they are. So you were like that. So now when you grow up and you think that you have independence to do things that you, for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who one who created you, you will have the say of this is right and this is wrong. So follow Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's righteousness and stay in His way. Also in Surah Al-Mujadalah, verse 1 to 2, قد سمع الله قول التي تجادلك في زوجها وتشتكي إلى الله والله يسمع تحاوركما إن الله سميع بصير. When the woman who came to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to complain about her husband, she was sitting in the room, and Aisha radiallahu anha was sitting in the same room. Aisha radiallahu anha did not hear what this woman said to the Prophet, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from above seven heavens heard her complaint and heard what she said to the Prophet. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave the judgment about what the woman was complaining. The woman was complaining about her husband, what he said, and that famous story about al-mujadala. Inshallah, but in the end, the very end, Inna Allah la'afuun ghafoor. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive and forbid, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala most forgiving. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is asking us to stay with His righteous way, and whatever wrong, stay away from it. By this way, we'll gain the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or who will gain the blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the mercy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We'll continue on inshallah with more of the verses and ahadith in the future. Khudwa inshallah aqul qawli hadha astaghfirullah li wa lakum. Wa Allah help us to purify ourselves in body, mind, heart and spirit. Wa Allah do not let our hearts deviate from the truth now that we have been guided, but grant us mercy from your very presence, for you are the grantor of bounties without measure. My Lord, help me to perfect my prayer and of my descendants. Our Lord, accept this prayer. My Lord, forgive me and my parents and all believers until the day of resurrection. Glory to Allah, Lord of majesty and honor, and peace be upon Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his family and all his companions. Praise to Allah, Lord of all creations. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم وأقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي للصلاة حي للفلاة خاتم الصلاة خاتم الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله إلا الله.
الله أكبر
الله أكبر.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين.
آمين.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. في قريش إلى فيهم أحد الشتاء والصيف ليعبدوا رب هذا البيت الذي أطعمهم من جوع وآمنهم من خوف. الله أكبر
الله أكبر.
سمع الله لمن حمده.
ربنا لك الحمد.
الله أكبر
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر
الله أكبر
الله أكبر
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر
الله أكبر.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين.
آمين.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إذا جاء نصر الله والفتح ورأيت الناس يدخلون في دين الله أفواجا فسبح بحمد ربك واستغفر إنه كان توابا. الله أكبر
الله أكبر.
سبحان الله لمن حمده.
ربنا لك الحمد.
الله أكبر
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر
الله أكبر.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. أستغفر الله.
أستغفر الله.